What's up, power boy? They send me better than you, Osama. Hey, Osama. Now, Jamaica Key, I go take Kokada. Yo, what's up, people? I go by the name of Yao Burk, and you'll check out. I want you guys to stay tuned. Always keep watching Hot Quiz on Multi CDV. I go by the name Yao Burk. Mogo, yeah, yeah.
Yes, welcome back to the channel. This is Multi CDB and we're live on Hot Quiz right now. I'm here with your next artist. This is the only show that brings the other side of your favorite celebrities to you, Charlie. Today I happen to be wearing a cap. This is branded, and I'm here with plantain chips. They said this is plantain chips with coated granules, and it's from Mama's chips. This is the only, so already Corona come. So if you say goodbye the one day roadside, you know, we'll get granules to take chew on. In the bab, you know, get granules to take chew on. So the number for them is 059-459-4520-866. 059-4520-866. That is Mama's chips. Call them right now and they are going to sort to you. I'd mention my name, you go get discount for top. All right, let's move it sharp. Today I happen to be here with one of the good, the invoice be very superb, Idebab. And I don't go talk plenty. Let me just introduce them, then we move on. Say, Bosu, I'm here with Yao Burk, Charlie. Bosu, welcome.
Thank you.
Okay, and we get to ask you normal questions, but there's a rule to the game. The rule to the game is you don't have to think about the answers. You just say whatever that comes in mind, then we move. Your mind it.
That'll be easy. My mind
it. Yeah, but anyway, this is Mama's chips.
Okay.
All right. From Mama's chips. Yeah.
From Mama's chips.
Yeah. So, and we want to present this to you.
Right.
You get me. It be so.
I hope it's crunchy.
Yeah, it's very crunchy and nice. It has this granot coated taste. Granot tube inside.
Thanks, bro.
It be so. Okay. So, are you ready?
Right. I'm ready.
Okay.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Okay, let's do it. So, what got you into music? Don't think about it. My next question was who inspires you, but. All right, what got you into music?
The inspiration.
Did you come from a music family?
Yes, slightly. My father was a chorister.
Oh, okay. Yes. But have you ever tried church styles before?
Yeah, I was a brigadier, but I wasn't singing. In church, what the activity I did for the church wasn't a singing thing. I was a drum major, drummer and trumpet and marching and stuff.
So which instrument do you still play now?
I can play the drum still. Mm-hmm. I can play a little bit of piano. Mm-hmm. And I'm learning the guitar as well.
But has it helped in your career so far?
It has, because if you don't know your keys and stuff as a musician, I mean, singing as well like this, you can't perform live band.
Yeah,
and
we'll
be performing live band back to back. So yeah, that little things, they help we get better.
Okay, so coming up, it has been live band for you, or it's just...
I would say coming up, because I started live band with MTN Hitmaker, and that time nobody knew me. That was a come up.
Mm.
I started with it. MTN Hitmaker 2017.
Mm.
You do live band like 8 times in a row throughout the competition. So I was with it.
Wow. But like, funny enough, I've only seen you once doing live band. Right. With I think you did it with Kelvin Boy at
Garage.
Yes, yeah, some guy being program under. Anyway, big ups.
Thanks.
Like, we know Ghana music industry is still growing, but we believe that we've gotten to some level that artists are still making money off streams and all this stuff. If you get a chance to change one thing about our music industry, what do you think you are going to change?
This matter there. Right now, I feel like if I say anything,
mm-hmm.
within the Yao Burk, if I say anything right now, am I... involve a lot of eyes or morph into my matter, critics and stuff, but me personally, I don't go to do anything about whatever is going on.
I mean, you see, you are a musician,
mm-hmm.
and the system is still around. You are in the system.
Mm-hmm. I know they see the system. That be the problem.
That it's invisible, but it's still controlling artists.
But me, I don't see that. It's mostly, I feel like there's a principle of life. You attract what you think of, or mm-hmm. what you want to.
Yeah.
Law of attraction. So if I sit there and feel like, okay, I'm encrypted by this system where I don't defend myself, so will it be. But for me, I feel like music is spiritual. Mm-hmm. If it connects with you, bro, we didn't listen to Jay-Z and say, some don't come here before.
Mm-hmm.
Some don't know say Ghana exists.
Mm-hmm.
How did their music get here? The connection, mm-hmm. the spirituality of the song. So I feel like it doesn't have to be because of an industry or a system before you go feel do your own thing as an artist. I mean, no. System no dey really trust.
Fine, but mm-hmm. you may say, ready, how things play, they could give you. See, I'm not saying that pinpoint people, I'll mention names.
Yeah,
I'm just saying from your own perspective. Like, and nobody can take that from you.
Right.
Nobody's your right.
For me, I'll say, I'm putting myself in this position. I'll say, for me, I relaxed for a while in my career for like mm-hmm. a year or two because of some things that I encountered. So to talk for myself,
mm-hmm.
I wouldn't say it's not good for me because me myself, riding on Asante start the drop again.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not like eligible for BET or Grammy. Then I can't talk to you, they're not supposed to make I go there. So it'd be bad industry.
Mm-hmm.
Nah, that's what I'm saying. I don't even want to center myself around the industry matter. Yeah, right now I'm just giving my people back to back music.
If you had to advise your 12-year-old self,
mm.
who wants to be a musician,
mm.
what kind of advice are you going to give?
Don't hastily jump into a contract. Don't hastily jump into a contract. Like, give it to people who can analyze it better.
Very well.
So they can take time to, I mean, explain to you before you get yourself into any kind of, I mean, banter.
Yeah, I'll beg. So with that said, right now you're not doing it.
All right, I'm working with New Accra Communications. They are like a network,
mm-hmm.
just like Ground Up is doing. We have that force. We have a lot of artists on board too, mm-hmm. which you guys will be seeing soon. But they won't make a shoot off small, and then
before
we can start bringing the new ones.
Yes. By the way, the new one with Kwame Nana, it's very dope.
Thank you.
And big ups for that. You always give us the classics, and I respect you for that. But I want to know, how did that song come by?
Banana. You see, they say, I watch your beard, I can use. Some girl, they had get before you, they can see. Chichia, you want that beard, some Drake, them are. Poor Miss, we need you. Mm-hmm. She said, no, she gets some friends and body cream, and then they go, if you get me spray, where I say, Rasta man, that time I get dread. Mm-hmm. Rasta man, I can go use spray every morning, take off our own grow beard.
Yeah.
Oh, they made that new Sam amount.
Mm-hmm.
I'll go and get the beard. So that was when the concept came, like, this thing, girls, it's be music stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I put it in there like that. Also, Pablo, you said, me better than you, Sama. Sama. Now, Jamaica, I go take, oh, basically, a lady who's authoritative. Anything you want to do, okay, I get.
Mm-hmm.
I go do for you. So I sent the record to Kwame, and he also brought what he has. He made the chorus, and then he put it in his verse. And it was crazy. Big shout out to Kwame and Pete.
It'd be so. But how's your creative process like?
Me, I have two ways. Mm. I have two ways. Mostly, self, I don't go even describe the ways, but mostly how it comes by is I get stuff like all of a sudden. Yeah, sometimes maybe I wake up. Me, I like listening to instrumentals a lot. I go feel sometimes they listen your song, but I don't go feel sing them. Do you know why?
No.
They like your song in beat.
You know, that's one thing people don't know. Artists go feel listen instrumental sound.
You understand?
You go feel listen. You can say they listen song.
No,
instrumental,
no.
See they listen.
They repeat.
You feel listen song. You don't know.
So yeah, I put beats on repeat like that, and then the inspiration sometimes drop like that, and sometimes some of the songs just come. Because you say, surprise, you know the keyboard and the guitar, and you know your melodies and stuff. Something you feel pop up. Something says maybe an anampe do more, then do them and things. No?
Yeah.
If the feet take them, then you do what? You renovate them, they do them better and some kind of stuff. Mostly to, or either ways, you go into the studio, the engineer will just start to play something or go take you like that. And then magic happens. The good thing about nowadays recording is that you can record it today, make changes anytime until you release it. So
Do you sometimes write?
I do write. I've never made a freestyle song. Any song I've brought out, I sit down to write.
Classic.
I have lyrics for it. Yeah.
Classic. But what is your most useless talent ever?
Thinking. I don't really like. If you think, then my auntie self feels say, no, the boy they go mad. I said, they come drop. I say, okay, so where I go, where I go, fit promo. That little thing, you know, like decisions with the management and stuff, they feel me cut things out. And they one side still, especially if I know they feel my legs like that. I do one side. So I feel they think it'd be useless talent. I know they like.
It'd be so. But what is your biggest fear in life?
Biggest fear? My biggest fear be say, I know that I don't want to do anything that will make any fan of mine lose interest or hope in me. That's my biggest fear. I pray I don't do anything on this way, I mean, going forward. Whatever that has happened, I feel like I've left it behind. I'm a happy person, living my happy life, giving the people music. That's what I want the people to focus on. But for my fear, I don't want to do anything, ever do anything that will make my fans or people who love me or support me lose interest in whatever I'm doing.
Yeah, and that is bad for business also.
Right, right.
It's true. I'm still here with Yao Beck and Charlie. I hope so you get your mama's chips. Mm-hmm. You did chew up some very crunchy, coated with granules. You get me? Yes, if you go buy the thing, the number go do the screen
top. The laminator, man.
You know, easy. Yes. But Yao Beck, what is the craziest experience with a fan you've ever had? I know, let's forget about the beard, man.
Hey, but the craziest one happened in a dance school, a dance senior high.
Mm.
Oh, then me, most of the stages I perform on, they mostly they get the barricade and things, so the fans when they feel breakthrough and you know they come close kind of stuff. But these SHS people, then do one for dining hall, so if they pass it, then somebody they hold you. Somebody took my shades and things. So I say, this be love. That stuff like that actually motivates me. Make me feel like, you know, if it be two people say they do this thing, show me. It means I have to feed them good music. Nothing but the good music. Yeah.
What surprises you about Ghanaians?
We know they support. That's what they marvel me. Self surprise be understatement too. If they marvel me, we go the place of continent or some other side people, them music, they want their own day. Then Grammy and things go come, they will go talk to you and people know they try.
But you put
like you go support. Ghana, top 10 iTunes, self, then Ghana they inside like one something.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, maybe we know we go feel left the tenor. I can't do this myself.
Yeah.
You can't do whatever you do yourself alone too. So we all challenge
the mindset. Myself,
yeah. They worry on ourselves and our support system be very poor.
It be very, very,
very poor.
Very poor.
Yeah.
Charlie, make a busy with this. What's your favorite body part?
My favorite body part? I feel my ears.
Yeah. Why your ears?
Sound.
It
what's the master know? If I not hear something, hey, always I won't make it be occupied. Always. So if I didn't leave it right now, make sure it's the airport or my car inside sound. So my ears, they need me. Well, sorry to say, if I turn deaf, like, go pay me for the rest of my life. Hey, so love song. Not to disrespect any deaf person, though. But just, you know.
Okay.
By the way.
Okay. So, yes. Do you prefer cats or dogs?
I prefer dogs. I like dogs.
I like cats.
Cats are slow. No, but some people like cats.
Yeah. Would you consider yourself intelligent or attractive?
I would say I'm intelligent. Attractive, the people now really try. They go see, you know, be me. So you only attractive, you know, go see you. Sometimes I only watch my face.
Yeah, it's so. So you're back, Charlie. Thanks for coming on the show. We are happy to have
Thank you.
And there's a new one out. I want you to talk to the people where to get it. If then they won't stream, where then for go streaming and just talk to my people.
Charlie, my people, it's your boy Yao Beck and Checker. I have a new one out featuring Kwame Nimp. The title is Banana. You can get the video out on YouTube and also the audio is on AudioMark, iTunes, Spotify, anywhere at all. Boomplay, anywhere you stream your songs. Go support your boy. Banana is out. Men featuring Black Sheriff is also out. You can search it too. And also more music coming your way. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Yao Beck Original. Yao Beck Original. Go. Yeah.
Fire. Yes, hot squeeze for you. And today we did it with Yao Beck. And thanks to Mami's Chips.
Right.
Mami's Chips.
Right.
Plantain chips with coated granules. Thanks to Mami's Chips. And it's crunchy for your Snacks, yeah. Y'all better get your own. Me too, I get my own. So yeah. I want you to go and call this number 059-452-0866. Call them and order for Mommy's Chips and you'll be sorted out. Subscribe, like, and share. Thanks for watching. Fire.